Hello everyone, thank you for taking the time to listen to this lecture about endoscopic vessel harvesting and why you should consider to go all in on it. My name is Ferdinand Kunick and I'm a physician assistant by training, and I'm the surgical support specialist for Terumo Cardiovascular, where I'm mainly responsible for EVH. Endoscopic vessel harvesting, or short EVH, has faced many misconceptions and skepticisms over the last decades since its invention. Today I want to talk about the main reasons for EVH, the first hurdles, and the disproving studies that paved the way for the broad acceptance and spread of this technique. When a new and innovative approach comes to the market, the first question is always, can it compete with what we do now? Of course, technology has its perks, and new devices can fulfill tasks in the blink of an eye that would take us humans hours or even ages. But this always comes with a certain twist, the costs. This brings us to our next obstacle. Can the costs be justified? And how is this justification measured? EVH requires an investment upfront. I will cover the benefits that the endoscopically harvested vein provides and what can be done to make it cost effective. At the end of the day, we all want to have the best outcome for the patients. This brings up the last question of this lecture, the clinical benefits. The new and fancy technology will only last when it proves to be truly beneficial for treatment quality, reliability, and patient's outcome, while being affordable to the majority of practitioners. The early studies were very skeptical and supported the assumption that EVH would damage the conduit and thus result in a worse outcome for the patients. With destroyed endothelium and a worse patency rate, the early testings were very pessimistic. But study design and the number of only 10 samples was raising questions about the integrity and the general validity. But as time went on and the prototypes from the early days evolved into high-functioning devices, the results got better accordingly, to a point where not only graft quality and patency became similarly good, but it also showed a big advantage for the patients with fewer infections and less pain during recovery. Also, the trials were conducted in the time of low experience and expertise for EVH. Comparing newcomers in EVH to the well-established open harvesting technique might have been suitable for the moment, but did not do it justice to the real potential. The chance of development was hit hard by these assumptions, and they were even harder to conquer. Luckily, with advancement of the devices and established training mechanisms in place, the time was right for new studies that dug deeper in the field of endoscopic vessel harvesting. The REGROUP trial assessed the occurrence of major adverse cardiac events in CABG surgery with a group of over 1,000 patients. They were randomly assigned to EVH or OVH, and the endpoint included death from any cause, non-fatal myocardial infarction, and repeat revascularization. The study design was specially chosen to improve on the disadvantages of previous trials, which included trainees in the process and thus resulting in a misleading outcome. The results showed that with the open technique, 15.5% of the patients had an incidence of MACE during follow-up, in comparison to 13.9% in the EVH group. In conclusion, there was no statistically significant differences in all-cause mortality, myocardial infarction, and repeat revascularization. This indicates the safe use of EVH with substantial benefits without the trade-off for patient safety or increased risks of adverse events. As visible in this graphic, the likability of adverse cardiac events was a little bit higher in the open group. This wasn't within the significant range, but it still shows a light tendency. Additionally, the rate of wound complications was lower in the EVH group, which was no surprise to the authors, as this was the main reason for the invention of the technique in the first place. It goes without saying that the implementation of a new technique comes with its difficulties. The old and commonly used ways are proven and the habits aren't easy to overcome. Especially the investment in new equipment and the learning of totally new kind of surgical procedure might cause some chaos in the standardized world of heart surgery. But the rising demand from physicians to offer better and less invasive treatments and patients openly asking for alternatives has come with its own chance for both sides. Here comes the business expression to mind. You have to spend money to make money. In this case, this would not be easy to answer, but rather be in a more health-oriented approach. You should invest for a better quality of the treatment. This study, performed by Rayo et al., found that the qualities gained by endoscopically harvested veins in comparison to open harvesting are more cost-effective. In easier words, the benefits outdo the spending. The costs are worth it. It was estimated that the treatment is cost-effective if the money spent is less than $30,000 per quali, meaning in this particular case that the study concluded for EVH to be the most cost-effective method of harvesting the great saphenous vein. But even this study had its flaws. With data from the US cases and a UK perspective, it may not withstand the critical evaluation of a real-life statement. To see another side of this discussion, it is necessary to count everything that EVH does economically for the hospital, with each individual case. This adds up over time, as in the same time, the initial costs are declining. Beginning in the procedure itself, it is safe to say, once fully mastered, the time difference in which EVH and OVH conduits are being taken from the leg won't differ significantly. Even further, the time spent will be eventually even shorter with EVH when taking a whole length of thigh to ankle from an obese patient, despite the pain that the patient will feel in recovery from his or her long scar. The resident who took the vein will also suffer from trying to quickly sew the leg all the way up while keeping bleeding inside. The risk of infections, seroma, hematoma, lymph edema, or necrosis is also present, while the time pressure of the main procedure of CABG remains. This misfit can lead to more complications and prolonged hospital stays, as well as costly and time-consuming wound care. Fewer hospital visits after discharge and an overall higher patient satisfaction are among the various benefits from regular EVH performance. It can also produce a better reputation from patients having good experiences from their stay. The additional implementation of SCPs or PAs can help with the sustainable high quality in EVH with the stable situation in the theater. With a simultaneous harvest of the IMA and great saphenous vein, time can be saved. In the end, you could even stand out in the field of heart surgery for implementing a new and minimally invasive innovative technique to make the choice easier towards your center. What can be done to ultimately implement EVH and reduce the cost of the procedure? See it as an investment in the future. The lasting components can be used for years to come and will provide a good quality for the period. Of course, a significant reimbursement would greatly help to give an incentive for the hospitals to have an easy refund warranty. In case of the US, shows that the broad use of EVH is associated with a large decrease in wound-related complications. As the technique becomes the standard of care, it will also flatten the learning curves in adopting it. The less it is used, the harder it will be to have sustainable quality and results. Teaching the residents and seniors would create a new cycle of learning, doing, and teaching to the residents' training schedule. In the beginning, the training can be provided by the company selling the EVH devices through highly skilled proctors or clinical specialists. These healthcare professionals will provide the best possible support in the operating room with the team. To conclude the mentioned points, is the impact big enough to make a difference for your patients? In short terms, all indicators point towards a huge clinical benefit. First of all, it is proven to be safe and non-inferior to OVH in multiple big meta-analyses in terms of patency and mortality. The technique is easy to learn and can be done by residents, SCPs, or PAs for continuous quality. It offers a special benefit for high-risk patients and those with a high risk for wound healing issues like diabetes or obese patients. It increases satisfaction and decreases the consumption of care and wound management resources. Additional skills can be acquired from the handling of an endoscope, which can be useful for other minimally invasive techniques like thoracoscopy or valve surgery. Current guidelines from the European Society for Cardiac Thoracic Surgery also favor endoscopic harvesting over open harvesting. Ultimately, the choice will remain yours. Thank you for your attention.